Hi there, what's up? My name's Kate, and this is my YouTube channel. It's basically going to be a beauty YouTube channel. Just to tell a little bit about myself since I'm new. My name is Kate. I'm from Michigan, but I live in San Diego, California currently with my boyfriend and our two dogs. I went to cosmetology school in Michigan, and I'm licensed in Michigan, but I can't practice cosmetology out here, unfortunately. So I decided to start this YouTube channel where I can still put out my work and do something that I'm really passionate about day to day. So go ahead and give me a like and subscribe, and yeah, go ahead and stay tuned. Okay, so today we are going to be doing my go-to everyday look. I do have oily skin, so I like to go in with a mattifying primer first. I use Makeup Forever mattifying just on my T-zone, because I like to stay matte, not oily, but I like to be glowy still. I like to have like a fresh base. Basically, so first I go in with the Makeup Forever, and then for the outer perimeter of my face, I go in with the Becca Backlight Priming Filter. I keep it away from my T-zone just because I am oily, but I like the way that this makes my makeup last, and I like the luminous look that it gives my skin. So, and then I always do my foundation first. So today I'm going to be doing my Smashbox Studio Skin, and I'm in the shade 1.1. And I do like to just like dot this all over my face. I don't really have a preference on full coverage or anything like that. Like, I don't need to be full coverage at all times. I have freckles, so if I'm getting full glam, I do lean towards a more full coverage, but just day to day, I like to be medium coverage. And then I'm going to take my L'Oreal sponge and just dab that into my skin. You can see my puppy. But yeah, I like to just basically have an even skin tone, so it doesn't really bother me if it's not like full coverage. I don't mind if my freckles pop through sometimes. And then for my concealer, I switch it up all the time. Tarte Shape Tape, of course, go to. Maybelline Age Rewind, go to. Recently, I've been using the Smashbox Studio Skin. It's the same as the foundation, so I like this combo. I do like to use a concealer that's a little bit lighter than my face, just to give me a nice highlighted look. not much of a baker, so to set that, I just like to take a smaller brush. This is just a Morphe brush. And I take my Urban Decay D Slick. And I set my under eyes so I don't get any creasing, because I do have like a lot of texture under my eyes and stuff. And then I like put a lot of powder, I guess excessive powder, around my T-zone. Just to help keep matte, like I said. And then I take Too Faced Cocoa Powder Foundation in the shade Fair, and I just set the rest of my face with this. Dust away if there's any extra of that D-Slick powder anywhere. I don't like to set my whole face with the mattifying powder just because it's not necessary. I don't have oily skin like all on my face. It's just mainly around my nose, my chin, and my forehead. Okay. So next I'm going to bronze, and I basically bronze and contour at the same time. I'm going to use the Lorac Tantalizer. Baked bronzer. I really like this shade. It's like, it's warm, but it's not like super orange or super red or anything. But I just bronze, but like contour at the same time, I guess. And I just use it on a Bare Minerals face brush. What I've always used. But see, it just like contours a little bit and then bronzes you up as well. I don't do like a harsh contour every day. I just don't feel it's really necessary for me anyways. Sometimes I wish I was harsh contour every day type of girl. And then I don't really contour my nose either. I just kind of add a little bit of color to it. I really need to learn how to contour my nose a little bit more. Yeah, adds a little bit of color and a little bit of definition at the same time. I do blush next. And today I'm going to do Tarte Ecstatic. It's just a nice peachy color. Peaches are my favorite for blush. Peachy coral colors. I do highlight my dog. And today I'm going to do Becca Opal. It's my favorite highlight. Well, actually, I can't say my favorite. I have a few favorites. I love the Smashbox and Casey Holmes collab. Love it. Sometimes I go in after and just add that on top of Becca Opal. But come on, that's just freaking stunning. Stunning! Ugh. Jamie Genevieve is actually the one that got me on this, because for like so many of her videos, she was just Becca Opal, Becca Opal, Becca Opal. I was like, shoot, I need that. Do a little bit on my nose, high points of the face. I like to do my highlight when I do my face because sometimes I like to like take it on my brow bone and stuff. I don't want to mess up my eyebrows or anything. So then I'm just going to take my blush brush and just make sure everything's blended nicely. There's not a harsh line of highlight or anything. And then now I do my eyebrows. And for that, I use the NYX Micro Brow Pencil. And I have it in the espresso and black. But, I don't know. Some days I like a less intense brow, and some days I like an intense brow. Today, I think I'm going to do an intense brow and use black. What? So I just comb through have pretty scarce eyebrows. And then I line underneath. And I have like an arch, but I like to make them appear straighter. Not so arched. I just go through. Underline the bottom and then outline the top as well. No one ever shows you their eyebrow tutorial in like every tutorial. Sometimes it's annoying because I'm like, dude, I want your eyebrows. Show me how to do them. And then I just go through and do some hair-like strokes through the tail. I like to make the tail more defined, or like darker, I guess, than the front. So I'll go in darker, and then as I get to the front, I kind of just lighten up a little bit. And then I go through the front and just give it a few hair-like strokes. I like the front of my brow to look bushier. I like wispy, bushy eyebrows. So there's that, and then I go through and I comb through it, make sure that you can't like see the lines that I drew in on the top or bottom or like throughout. Make them all blended. Cute. And then to set them in place, I use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Tinted Eyebrow Gel in Espresso. I get the tinted one. I like the clear one because it sets them way better than the tinted one. But because my natural hair color isn't black, I like the tinted because it just gives my brows a darker color and makes them look more natural. Darker. Hey, get down, baby. Okay. And I comb the front brow. Hair is like straight up, so wispier. And there you have it, my eyebrows. So after I do my eyebrows, I move on to the eyes. Sometimes I like to do a basic brown eye. Brown eye. Oh, God. Basic brown, like, crease. And sometimes I like to do a coral crease. And today I think I'm going to do a coral. Just depends. Sunny out. It's feeling like summer, so. And I usually do the Too Faced Peach palette when I do a coral eye. And I always go and take Peaches and Cream and set my whole eye base with it. Just in case there's like foundation or concealer that wasn't set yet. Give us a nice base. Then I go in with an Ofra blending brush. I got this in my cosmetology kit, actually. So, I don't know. Professional Makeup 21. It's a green handle. And I take Georgia, which is just a light pink color. And I put that in my crease. Just do it messily. It's really light, so it's not... I don't know. I just do it just to start us off. I don't know. It's not really necessary, I guess. It's not like I'm doing a really dark eye that takes a lot of blending or anything. Okay. And then once that's in, I go in with the star of the show, which is Candied Peach, which is like one of the only peach shades in this palette. Which I never really realized until I saw someone's video like saying how it's a peach palette but there's like one peachy shade. I was like, wow, that's so true. But it's a good peachy shade, so. And I love this palette, regardless. So yeah, I just put this all in my crease. I really blow it, like blend it up all the way up to my eyebrow, basically. I like a really blown out eyeshadow look just because my eyes are hooded, so if I just like really focused it in the crease, you wouldn't really be able to see it. So I like to bring it up. You can hear my dog's squeaker toy. Oh man. And the same thing with this eye. And if you hold your eyeshadow brush like this as you're blending up, it'll just help you create a like more diffused look going up and focus it less like coming down, so it keeps the lid space open. It's a trick I learned from Jamie as well. So yeah, so this is basically it for my everyday. If I'm going to go more dramatic and I still do a peachy look, I'll add either Pure or Summer Yum into the outer corner and just deepen it up, but still keep it pretty peachy. And then I always take Candy Peach, which is the same peachy shade as the top, and put it under my eye. And I like the bottom of my eyes to be pretty smoked out too. Not really smoked out, but like blown out. Blended out as well. Just makes your eye look a lot bigger. I don't know. So yeah, that's basically it for the eyes. Sometimes I'll add a shimmer on the lid. Today I don't really feel like having a shimmer. But if I were to, I would usually do Nectar or Bellini. They're just like simple shimmers. But I'm going to go back to Peaches and Cream, which is the first shade that we set the eyelid with. I'm just going to brighten up the lid again. Keep it nice and big. then I like to do a wing almost daily. And for a winged liner, I use the Maybelline New York Master Precise by iStudio felt tip liner in black. So I just draw a straight line out from the corner of my eye and then bring it back to my eyelid. And then I fill it in. Give it a nice flick. And then I just slightly line my eyelid into the inner corner. Just getting thinner as we go in. Then I do it on this other side, but to make sure that they're like both going at the right angle, I usually look straight into a mirror and then make a dot. Where I think I should connect it to. That's my trick to getting even winged liner. Okay, now I'm done with both wings. Looking pretty good. I'm gonna move on to mascara. I don't normally ever wear false lashes, so I always curl my lashes and use a waterproof mascara just because I feel it holds my eyelashes better. And the mascara I use is the Maybelline The Colossal Volume Express Cat Eyes. It has like the cat print on the cap of it. And then I always do more than just one coat, but I like to move to the bottom lashes after I do the first coat of the top lashes. Usually I do this before my mascara, but I forgot, and I usually put NYX Wonder Pencil in light in my waterline. Yeah, it makes such a difference. I love it. And for my inner corner highlight, I'm just going to take the same highlight I used on my face, Becca Opal. And then put a little bit more on my brow bone. Put a little bit on my cupid's bow. Nice. And then for lips, I don't wear lipstick every single day. I'm more of a gloss girl. I love glosses. It's just easier. I'm gonna be eating, and I just don't feel like getting like crusty lips or anything like that. So I tend to wear glosses most of the time unless I'm not gonna be eating or doing anything like that a lot of the time. So I'm gonna use the Kylie Cosmetics gloss in Literally today. It's one of my favorite glosses. It's so opaque and like stunning. I actually just got my Sephora order, so scratch that. I might not be using the Kylie lip gloss because I did order Marc Jacobs lip gloss. I mainly got hair care items and like skincare stuff. I didn't really get a lot of makeup, but I did get the Marc Jacobs Enamored High Shine Gloss Lip Lacquer in Pretty Thing. Woo, girl. Oh yeah, that's pretty. I really love this applicator. This is my first one I ever got from Marc Jacobs. It's really pretty. I like it. So, this is my finished look. Bring you a little closer. It's just really simple, really easy. I want to wear makeup, but I don't want to go full glam just because I'm most likely just going to be hanging out with my pups, my boyfriend. So I don't want to be bothered by all the glitz and glam, but it's still really pretty and feminine, and I'm confident wearing this to dinner or something like that. But yeah, so thank you so much for tuning in. This is my first video, so everyone is obviously going to be new, so please subscribe. My content will only get better from here. I'm thinking about getting a whole setup, lights, a camera, lights, camera, action, everything like that. I just have to figure everything out. I just wanted to do a test run, basically, and see if this is something that I would want to invest time in. I love makeup. I do my makeup all the time. I do other people's makeup. So it is something I'm super passionate about. The timing is never fully right, I don't think. I think any time is right to start this. So I guess now is better than never. Right? Right. But yeah, so please give me a like, subscribe, everything like that. But anyways, yes, like and subscribe. Thank you so much for tuning in. And I'll see you in my next video.